in the lab, doing stuff, making something. Again, slightly higher power than before, but first off, I want to thank everybody who helped out with the Patreon thing. I mean, that video last time about the Patreon was going to be, you know, charged sales taxes and urge people to stick in there, and boy, I was I was overwhelmed. Not only did my patrons stay, but many of them, hundreds of them, decided to put in a little bit more, and it's really just, it's really pushed FranLab closer to our 2020 goal of being, like, completely self-sufficient. It's, like, very close. It's, like, I think with, over the weekend, with the pledges that came in, and a lot of people, a lot of new people came to Patreon, and a lot of new top team FranLab members. Thank you to everyone who came to Patreon to help out, and those of you who were on Patreon who chipped in a little more. It's just gonna make all the difference. So we're very close to, like, so close to closing the financial gap for 2020. I'm very optimistic that if we can bring in some more people in the upcoming months, that, you know, we can be 100% funded by the end of the year. And that would be great. Also, for work, I know I talked about this in the past, that you can't get, you know, the cool flow masks for doing work in the U.S., but I was able to get some, because it turns out, even though you can't buy the cool flow N95 masks in the U.S., you can get them in Australia. And even though they will not sell from, if you go to Australia, eBay or whatever, they will not ship to the U.S. for, I guess, obvious reasons. But I just happen to have a very good friend in Australia who was able to procure me some N95 masks and ship them out. And this one, actually, my friend Dave Jones at the EV blog had these. He said, I guess he was running out, I guess, his old lab, because he's got a couple labs, and he's running out his old space, but the tenant moved out and left a bunch of stuff, and one of the things they left was a box of N95 mask, like, brand new. So he said, this is a freebie, and he just sent it to me, and thanks, Dave. I really appreciate it. I have several friends here in Philly who really can use some masks, so I'm going to be, you know, divvying them up between a few people that I know need them. But thanks, Dave. And if you need them for work, you know, if you've got social media and got some friends down under, they can probably get a box for you at the local store and send it to you, and you can get back to work and work safely. So the other thing I wanted to put in here, this is just a quick video. You remember a few months ago, I guess, well, a couple months ago now, I got some brand new HEPA filters for the lab. I got three machines. I got two of these classic 605s, and I also got this 280i model, which is the smaller one, and I splurged and got the activated carbon odor absorbing filters for all the machines, and they were running for a good, you know, 6 weeks or so, 7 weeks, and I started noticing, strangely, a very, like, sour odor. Like, I got one in the office, I got one near the front door, and I got one the 280i is there by my bedside, and I thought, well, I was just noticing whiffs of, like, a vinegary smell every now and then it got more and more, and in the office in particular, it just got kind of overwhelming. And using my snifter, I found that, yeah, it was coming from the actual HEPA filters themselves, the activated carbon filters. All three machines, pretty much at the same time, started to get sour, produce a vinegary kind of smell. And this really perplexed me because, and I even contacted Blue Air about it, and they really had no answers. Just offered to replace the filters, but you know, there's got to be a reason for it. And doing some research online about activated carbon granules and such, and found that most of the activated carbon that you find is activated chemically and contains like acids and some other things. And so you think that that might be what's going on, some releasing some acid. But Blue Air advertised on their website that they actually use no chemicals in activating their carbon. It's a naturally activated coconut carbon, I guess, from coconut husks, I guess. But yeah, it's just very mysterious. And what makes it more mysterious is first of all, you'd think, it would be obviously, absorbing some kind of an odor, some kind of a odor or a gas that's reacting with the activated carbon and producing an acid smell. But all three machines are in very different locations with very different sort of types of air. I mean, the one by the front door is absorbing sort of the hallway stink of cooking and stuff like that. The one in the office is, in the office with all the office stuff. The one in the bedroom is just by the bedside. So there's really nothing in common between the three as far as things that are around or outgassing of things or anything. And I think the only reference I found online about activated carbon turning kind of sour had to do with absorbing ozone. But a lot of people would say, well, it's obviously, the ozone if the machines are producing ozone. But one of the things that Blue Air are famous for, and the reason I invested in them, is that they are certified, independently certified, to produce zero ozone. So, it's not likely that it's that. But I put it out to you, if anybody has any of these Blue Air filters with the odor-absorbing, special filters, if you've had something similar happen, let me know. And if you are an expert in the sort of air purification field, and if you've got some expertise about activated carbon and what it could be, let me know, because it's something I really want to solve. I mean, these cartridges are supposed to have a 6-month lifespan at least, and I certainly don't want to replace them every 6 weeks if they're going to be turning funky. But I'd really like to get to the bottom of it and find out what the source of the issue is, so that my place doesn't smell like, sour apples or vinegar. So anyway, a little mystery that I'm putting out to you to help me solve. Through all of this, my favorite radio station, WPRB in Princeton, they're still on the air. They found a way to run the radio stations that all the DJs can broadcast remotely from their own home studios. That's been really awesome. And they missed their fun drive this year because they, it's something that they do every spring, and they weren't able to do it because of the pandemic, because they're, all kind of broadcasting from home. But, if you really like freeform radio that's done by real DJs, really good taste in music, you can tune in to WPRB online at WPRB.com. I support the station, and if you really love freeform radio, then I encourage you to do the same. Give a donation to the radio station, just like I do every year. WPRB.com. And listen. All right. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks. I'm feeling better, not 100%, but I've got windows where I can, get the energy to do some stuff, and this was one of them. So I took the opportunity to do some catch up on the news. Again, thanks to Dave Jones, and thanks to everybody who came to Patreon to really kick up the numbers and get us closer to our 2020 goal of being fully funded thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody on that there Patreon. All right. Thanks. I'm Fran. I'll be back here real soon and probably maybe back at the factory now that I got some masks to work with. I know I got some projects to do over there, so we'll see what I can get accomplished in the upcoming weeks. Thanks. Bye!
I'm Fran.